In this video today, we're going to show you the basics of getting to know your new Cleartouch board that you have in your classroom. So first, when you turn on your board, you might notice that it looks like the date and the time, and you're going to see some different applications here on your board. So this is actually the Android side of your board, which you are not limited to. I'm going to show you some great features throughout these video sessions where we look at the PC side and how much the PC side has to offer. Honestly, at this point, the Android side is not going to offer you too much, but I want you to be aware that there are two different sides of your board. So looking at your Android side, if you want to switch it over to your PC side, all you're going to have to do is swipe up from the bottom of your screen, and then you're going to look for the blue dot that's located within your HDMI icons. So you'll see my blue dot is located on HDMI 3. So I'm going to go ahead and swipe up and click HDMI 3 so that takes me back to my PC side. So on the PC side of the board, you'll notice that it is running off of your teacher station. So in thinking about that, if there was something that you needed to show in Google Chrome or on an internet browser, then you would just open that up from your PC side. There's no need to use the Android browser to show something on the internet. So I can easily show anything within Google Chrome here. YouTube videos, websites, Google Docs, all that stuff will show easily from your Google Chrome browser. If you need to run your document camera, then you should have a program on your desktop that's called Sphere or Sphere 2. If you need help learning how to use Sphere or Sphere 2 with your document camera, then make sure that you reach out to your campus digital learning specialist so we can show you how Sphere works. On your PC side, you'll also notice that there is this little arrow, and it's going to be on both the left side of your screen and the right side of your screen. So in this little arrow, these actually run off of the Android side, but they give you quick annotation tools if needed. So if you click this home button, it takes you back to the Android side because they're Android side tools. So again, to switch back, you're gonna swipe up and look for your blue dot on your HDMI icons. Clicking that arrow again, you're gonna see this green whiteboard area, which is called Note. And Note is going to be meant for just a white space if you need it when you're in one of those quick teaching moments. So with Note, you do have access to some tools here at the bottom. One of those is which is a pen. If you wanted to write with your finger, you could, or you could pick up one of your Cleartouch pens and write with your Cleartouch pens. But again, that's going to be meant just for those quick annotations within a teaching moment. So I'm going to go ahead and close out of Note. If you want to explore some of those tools on your own, then you're more than welcome to. And then back here on the PC side, I'm going to go ahead and just open up my Google Chrome browser. And I'm going to just go to a new tab. And let's say that, you know, this is a document that I want to show my kids that's in Google Chrome, but I want to write on this document. So again, you have those quick annotation tools over here with your arrow. And so if you click on the one that looks like a pencil, then you'll see that you have a little toolbar that pops up right here. So this allows you to write on anything on that PC or Android side, again, with your pen or with your finger. So something that's commonly misunderstood with these Android quick annotation tools is there is no way to erase just a small section. There actually is if you use the palm side of your hand. So I'm gonna erase just that smiley face by using the side of my hand, and that activates that eraser for you. Now, if you wanted to erase all of those annotations, then you would want to use your sweep tool, and that will take everything off. Keep in mind with these quick annotation tools that it does create an overlay on top of your screen, so you cannot scroll and keep those annotations with you at that point.